We will now proceed to our next speaker, a world-class athlete, a F45 Madrid owner, Real Madrid and EuroLeague legend, Mr. Joe Arlaugas. He will talk to us on the subject of gym adaptation in the post-COVID-19 era and present the F45 Madrid case. Mr. Arlaugas, over to you.
Hello, how are you?
Good, you?
Good. Thanks for having me. Well, first of all, I want to say the typical thing that we say nowadays. No, I hope everybody's happy, safe, and healthy. Doing well, families, friends, and everything that's going on in this world is a little bit crazy. But that's the most important thing, that everybody's happy and healthy. And I'd like to also take this moment before we begin to thank Active Media, Heidi's just showed up in the screen, and Akis and the whole team of one of the most innovative companies that I've been associated with over the last couple of years. And just the fact that we're sitting here in this video conference right now in this Front Runners Sports Management Conference is just an indication of just how up on the times this company is, and how pleased I am and honored I am to not only work with you guys at Active Media, but also be a part of this Front Runners with so many important people, which I don't feel I'm that important, but I'm here anyway, so I enjoy it. Hey, Artis, how are you, my man?
Hello, everyone. I'm back here. The stage is yours, and thank you so much for your kind words.
Thank you guys for having me. As I was saying, I want to get started, but for the people who don't know anything about F45, I have a short video. I think you guys have the video to load it up, and I might as well start with that just for everybody to get an idea of what F45 is about if you don't already know. And I think this video kind of captures the essence of what the gym, at least it was about before COVID. So if we could play the video, that would be great.
At F45, we believe that the best exercise is simple, effective, and most importantly, great fun. We prepare our members for everyday life by drawing from a vast array of exercises to deliver a new workout every day that combines functional human movement with high-intensity interval training. That is, short, sharp bursts of exercise alternated with slower recovery phases in a quick 45-minute workout. In many ways, F45 is all the things you're not getting from a typical gym. We're not about treadmills and stationary weight machines. Instead, you'll find kettlebells, ropes, sandbags, barbells, and medicine balls, as well as ample space for running, jumping, climbing, lifting, and throwing. There's also no feeling of intimidation or isolation. We train as a team, and our workouts can be scaled to all levels of fitness. Lastly, there's no chance of boredom because you're guaranteed to never do the same workout twice. Every class is programmed by a team of elite trainers before being rigorously tested and refined to ensure the body's muscle groups and energy systems are worked in deliberate sequences to maximize the intended physical benefit. Our intensive cardio-based workouts are designed to kickstart the body's metabolism and increase muscle definition, while our resistance programs help to build that muscle which will melt the fat. When it comes to our hybrid systems, we've really broken the mold. Members can now train like a pro surfer, an elite quarterback, or just sweat it out in front of a live DJ for the ultimate fitness party experience. The end result is a customer who's finally engaged with their fitness. They have more energy, visible toning, and a body that can stand up to the challenges of day-to-day life. Training well is not about maximizing your time at the gym. It's about maximizing the quality of your workout and maintaining that consistency over time. But our world-class programs are just the start. Members get a consistently high-quality experience every time with the help of our proprietary exercise TV technology. And real-time heart rate monitoring via F45 Lionheart ensures that everyone can train at just the right level of intensity for their level of fitness. Add to that live DJ sessions and a premium fit out, and you've got a fitness experience that will leave you exhausted, exhilarated, and begging for more. Numerous tests have confirmed the body's maximal response to prolonged exercise takes place in the first 45 minutes. Want to know more? Schedule a call with me using the button below.
Perfect. I hope everybody got a good look at the video, because I'll probably refer back to it a little bit during my little speech now. I want to go back to the beginning. I think it's important to go from the start for me with F45. My daughter worked in Qatar in Doha, and she got a job from a friend of hers, and that job was being a head trainer or one of the trainers at an F45 in Qatar. Of course, to be really honest with you guys, I wasn't really excited about my daughter going to Qatar, you know, number one, because it's so far away. Number two, because as Americans, we have a different idea towards their societies and their cultures. She was having a struggles when she was there in the beginning, and she asked me to come visit. So I jumped on a plane, I went to visit her, and mostly I went to visit her because I wanted to just make sure she was okay and see where she was living and see what she was doing, so forth and so on. And she says, Daddy, she says, I'm teaching classes tomorrow from 8 o'clock in the morning till 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Would you mind taking a class with me? And it was typical. I said, come on. I said, come on, Tess. This is my daughter's name, Tess. I said, come on. I said, those classes are for girls. They're for women. They're not for men like me who likes to go to the gym and like spend an hour and a half, 2 hours in the gym and like run on the treadmill, lift weights and act like a man, you know? And that was my thought process. And she's like, Daddy, and I had like 8 days or 9 days to be with her while I was there. And she's like, Daddy, please, 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 she kept begging me. She said, it'd make me feel so happy if you took the class with me. So I said, okay. I joined the class. And it ruined my vacation because I worked out for 36 minutes. I sweated like I've never sweated before in my life. I was sore in places that I never knew existed on my body. I had muscles that I never knew existed on my body. And I couldn't get out of bed for the next 2 days. And I thought to myself, I said, what am I doing in a gym for 2 hours every day? Especially getting up to my age where I'm at now, where I'm now 55. This was when I was like 52, 53. I said, this is the future for me. This is the way to work out. This is, if I want to stay in shape, this is the way I need to stay in shape. Quick, fast, get to the point. Like the video said, I mean, the most we achieve is in the first 45 minutes of our workout. The rest of the time, we're just really wasting time. And I liked it. I liked it. And I was approached by the owner of the gym in Qatar, which is in the Pearl, actually. They're the smallest gym. Most of the gyms are very small. They're boutique gyms. Most of them are very small. They're the smallest one of all of them in the world. I think there's over 3,000 or 4,000. I'm not even sure how many. They had the highest amount of volume and the highest amount of sales in the entire world. Obviously, number one is because the Qataris pay a higher price. They had over 600 members that were paying, I think, maybe 300 to 400 euros a month to go there. So their volume was incredible. And so the owner asked me if I would be interested in opening one in Madrid, because he has them all over. He has a couple in Charleston. He has some in Bangkok. He has them all over the place. He has like 12 of them. So I hesitantly said yes, because I hesitantly said yes because my life was perfect. My life was EuroLeague basketball, podcast, teaching kids basketball, doing my articles. My life was perfect. I was able to travel to Greece whenever I was asked to for certain conferences, for certain tournaments, for pro-ams, and everything was as simple as can be. And I knew opening up a business would just destroy my life. I knew it was going to change everything. So I pretty much said no. And then they called me up with an offer. Him and his partner called me up with an offer that was one of these offers that personally I couldn't refuse. It was one of those offers that if you refuse it, you'd regret it for the rest of your life for not doing it, because you'd always ask yourself what could have been or what should have been. And now that I've done it, even though I'm enjoying it, I regret it, because now it's part of my life on a daily basis. I do this 24 hours a day. As I was sitting here waiting for the video to come, I'm changing classes, people in classes, because of everything. Let me go back. It was a 2-year process from that time until We found the location. We built out a location. We did everything we needed to do. And we were supposed to open on January 15th of 2000. Things get delayed. It's a franchise. So with the franchise, everything has to be perfect. The stars have to be in the perfect place. The stripes have to be in the perfect place. Everything has to be to detail. We have to do a Zoom video just like this, measuring where the stars are, if they're 40 centimeters apart, if they're, you know, whatever, 1 meter and 50 centimeters from the floor. It's a tedious and annoying process, to say the least. And it makes you hate the franchise in so many words. It's so much easier to say. It makes you hate the franchise because they made it so difficult for us to open up the doors because everything had to be perfect. The construction went a little bit slower than we expected. So instead of our January 15th opening, we were delayed just a little bit under 2 months. And we got all our paperwork from the town, from the government, from the franchise, from the builder, everything on March 11th. Well, March 11th was our Zoom meeting. March 12th was our final approval. And March 12th at 6 p.m., Madrid shut down, totally shut down. So we never actually had the ability to run a class. We never had the ability to even open up the door as a physical business yet. Even to the point where when I asked for government help, they refused us the help because we were not actually physically open yet. It didn't matter that I had a company that was running this gym. It didn't matter to them. It's the fact that we never even got to open up the doors because of the COVID situation. So now, I mean, this is, I guess I've caught everybody up to where we are at this point and why I'm here, I guess. We spent the next 3 months trying to be as creative and as innovative as possible with no customer base. We had about 420 people signed up for what we called the founding membership. Okay, it was a founding membership for 128 euros a month. You got 2 weeks for free to come in. We gave you a bag, we gave you a gift, we gave you the lion heart like they talked about. And we had over 400 people that we spent about $2,000, $2,500 a month going up for those 6 months in marketing to bring these people in. And we're bringing these people in, you have to understand, in a gym that doesn't exist and an idea that doesn't exist in Spain yet. So that was a very strenuous time also just to get these people to join in. So March 12th comes along and we lose everybody, essentially. I mean, they're all in our database, they're all in our list, but March 12th comes along and we decide that it was time to do anything we can, Instagram, Zoom. We had a lot of help from the franchise on that aspect as far as the Zoom was concerned. They immediately signed a contract with Zoom. Everybody, all of us got a free business account with the Zoom people. We started to run classes as much as we can, but again, we had no followers. We had no people that knew what we were doing, and it made it very difficult. We did some Instagram every day. We did an Instagram video with one of our trainers who helped us out a lot during that time where we're all isolated at home. But now I'm going to go back and talk about what franchise did for us in such a difficult time. Obviously, everybody's been different. Each country has been different as far as regulations are concerned, when they open, when they close, when they were quarantined. We were essentially from March 12th until June 8th without being able to open. We were able to open a couple, like 1 week before June 1st, but it was only on an individual basis. And our class, as you saw, our classes are not individual. They're classes with up to 36 people, you know, 27 to 36 people a lot of the times. As you saw in the video, everybody's very close together. It's a community, and you build this community by getting everybody close together and slapping high fives And literally the workouts are based on survival. You know, you say you survive the end of the workout because they are so difficult. They're so intense, but they're so quick for 36 minutes. And that's when you're given the high fives and you're given the hugs and the body bumps and everything else. Well, obviously nowadays that's all out the window. That's not at all possible anymore. So what the franchise did for us, which was pretty amazing, was number one, with the Zoom home workouts, they immediately developed products, two different packages, one that came in like a little backpack where you can have like some kettlebell weights, some small weights, some bands and things like that, which I think cost like about 75 or 80 euros. And then there was another one that was bigger, had a little bit more weights to it, a little bit more stuff. So your at-home workouts could be more complete with what we usually do. What we did with Zoom is we decided to do everything body weight because we don't know who has equipment in their house, who doesn't have equipment in their house. I've seen many people using, like, you know, the 5 gallon jugs of water. You see, we've seen all those crazy videos during the quarantine that everybody saw, but we decided that we wanted to do just regular body weight because the last thing we want to do is have someone throw up 5 gallon of jug of water and on their shoulders and get injured and then blame us. So we were a little tentative to do the weight thing. When we opened, the franchise, who I despised and who I hated for 3 months, saved our life. And they did something that no other gym right now in Madrid has. And that's what I think has been our success. The secret to our success is they stationed off each person in 2 meter stations. Okay. I'm sure a lot of you are probably saying, well, every gym does that. It's true. A lot of gyms are doing that now and they're stationing people off and they're making sure that the proper distance are there because that's what the government demands. And that's what we have to do as a business. Otherwise we get fined. But what they did was they developed a way, as you saw in the video, there's televisions. Each person follows the television. You have your screen now. All right, before station 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 were stations that you walked around the room and you worked out and you moved around the room and you high-fived everybody. Now everybody stays in their same spot. The difference is that what we do better than any other gym right now in Madrid is each station that we have, there's 9 stations total. We can double up some people if they live together, if they're married, or if they're just good friends or family, whatever. We can double them up in one station if possible. Each station has different material, okay? So if you imagine station 1 has boxes for jumping, has dumbbells for certain types of weightlifting, it has barbells with weights, also with disc weights, has a jump rope in it. Station number 2 has 4 sets of different weighted kettlebells. It has a bicycle in it, a stationary bicycle. It has sliders because it's on like a rug type thing, a grass, artificial grass in the front. If you saw in the video, the blue part up front. So now each person has a different station that they train in. So all 9 people are doing a workout, but it's always a different workout. So if Hardis comes to my gym on Monday and he says, I want to do this workout on station number 1, we say, okay, that's great. I just come on, put your shoes on, let's go. We'll put you on station number 1. If he comes on Wednesday when it's a cardio day, we make sure that he goes to a different station, so it's a completely different workout. Our success has been the fact that so many people have come to us because they're tired of doing the same thing over and over again. They're tired of working out the same way over and over again. And every time they come to us, they're like, I could do something different every day. The videos change every 3 weeks. So essentially, if you've done every station, every workout, every different workout that we have, and you keep going around and around, after 3 weeks, you probably can repeat the same workout. But that's when we change all the exercises that come up on that TV. So it's been an extremely good experience in the end to be part of a franchise. If they didn't make this move, we would have been closed down. It would have been impossible for us to continue. Like I said, we've been open from June 8th. It's just been up and down. It's every time I feel like the wheels come off of the ground when, you know, an airplane taking off, it just seems like something puts us back down on the ground. And we've had a great month so far. My goal is about 300 customers, because I said we're a small gym. We're not a big gym that has 5,000 clients. My goal is 300, and right now we're halfway there, 6 months into this. And I feel like we're about to explode if everything stays good. And I know the COVID issue here in Spain is growing more and more. We clean all our equipment after every class. Everybody comes in, they're safe, they're secure. We had one week in the beginning of October where we had a couple of clients called up that said they had contacted, or they've been in contact with somebody, they were feeling good, they weren't feeling good, they went and got tested, and they tested positive. So we shut the gym down for those 4 or 5 days. We were lucky that was right in the beginning or middle of October, where there was a long weekend. I think in Greece, it's the same long weekend. I think it was going to be when we were going to do the artist. What's the name of our event?
There? Our event, you mean?
In October, yeah.
Navarino Challenge.
Yeah, Navarino Challenge.
Okay.
I think it was the same weekend of Navarino Challenge that happened to us. So we shut the gym down. We fumigated. We did a whole ozone cleaning. And since then, knock on wood as much as I can, we haven't had any COVID issues, but it's been a difficult challenge. I've seen people quit throughout this. I have a different mentality, as most of you know. If you're listening to me, you probably know that I played basketball and I was fortunate enough to be on a lot of winning teams. My mentality is, 1 year from now, I want to look back and say that, excuse my language, but I kicked COVID's ass, and we stayed open, and we persevered, and we succeeded in spite of everything that we have going against us, where other people's attitude might be the fact that they look back a year from now and say, I shut down because of COVID. It really wasn't my fault. And that may happen to me. It may happen. I don't know. I'm not 100% sure. We're every day is a new day for us. It's a new challenge. Our capacity is limited to only 14 people. So my problem right now is I have 150 members that are paying, and I have a bunch of people new that I have to get into my gym so that I could convert them into members so I can grow to that 300. I'm doing 8 classes a day, and I get 14 people in my class a day. So if you do the numbers, that's 112 people that I could go into my gym on a daily basis if I'm at full capacity.